Dear viewers, you are my greatest inspiration. Your kind words of appreciation motivate me to keep making more videos. Don't you find celestial geometry incredibly fascinating? Yes, me too. Comments from two of my viewers inspired me to make a video on the topic of upcoming Lunar Standstill 2025. There are so many other key topics associated with Lunar Standstill that I had to make 5 separate chapters. Chapter 1 contains the preface and a quick glance over basic concepts, geometrical aspects, and key definitions, so the discussions in the next chapters make most sense to the viewers. Chapter 2 gives a rapid, concise lesson on the Sun's path-related topics. This is Chapter 3 that presents a profound insight into the third motion of the Earth and precession of the equinoxes. After you finish watching this video, please continue to the next chapters. More suspense is always on its way. Please keep watching. Please note. Before I get to the prime topic of Lunar Standstill, it's absolutely necessary that I demonstrate through elaborate illustrations what the third motion of the Earth means, and also how and why precession of the equinoxes occurs. Even though most of you are already aware of these, it would be practical to have a quick glance and keep it all in mind, in order to avoid confusion. Just to point out number 1 and number 2, the first and the second motion, rotating and revolving, daily and annual. Before we get into the third. Enough about the rotation and revolution, now, what about the third? We all know very well, that Earth's axis of rotation is tilted relative to the orbital plane. In addition to the first and the second motion, rotation and revolution, This oblique axis spins around in a circular precession like this, though rather sluggish. Please observe that the points of intersection are not static. and what is the consequence of that? Please remember to like, subscribe, share.